Hello everyone, and welcome back to my playthrough of Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, the game, Complete Edition. Today I am proudly jumping into the second part of this game as we take on, well, the chapter based on the book itself, Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, Book 2. Possibly one of, not definitely not my favorite out of all the books, but used to be my favorite to read and reread. And I'm super excited to get back into this game. I had a great time with the first episode. I did a little grinding off screen just to get Scott built up better, but I can't pull off the late fees yet. So we're just going to jump right into the game once I get my sound corrected. Just a second. And we're back. Sorry about that. My sound decided it didn't want to work. We're back into the game. Sorry about that cut. And Scott is now level 9. After some major grinding, and we are going straight into Casa Loma's film set. Okay. Yep, there he is. I forget this guy's name. I'm gonna try and learn it, but I don't remember it. I remember that in the movie, I know he's played by Chris Evans. Yes, the Chris Evans. And I think he is one of the best evil exes in the series. He was a really good character. I just remember a ton about him. I remember his fight with Scott really well. Well, at least in the book. I don't remember how it goes in the game. Hey, girls. Ow. That's stupid. Okay, so Scott has some upgrades, not a ton. I have a couple of new moves, but I'm not very good at using any of them. So we're just going to see what happens. Lucas Lee, right. Okay, so yeah, his name is Lucas Lee, is the second evil ex. If any of you are curious what these two are supposed to be, my answer is anime. Yeah, just anime. Ah. And obviously, that big guy in the dinosaur costume is a reference to Dig Dug. Aww, that's cute. And now we have the green screen people flailing around like idiots. Yeah, bust up your movie. What are you gonna do about it? Right, so Lucas Lee is a major movie star and also a professional. And also a professional skateboarder. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Nice! Okay. And he uses both of those abilities to his advantage. Oh, God, I hate these guys. Okay, I remember some things about this game. Not a lot, but I remember stuff like this. These enemies are a pain in the ass. Let me try and use a weapon. Ooh, a key! Maybe that'll be helpful. Assuming I don't throw it. Wait, do I need to get a running jump? Oh, sweet! That actually worked! I used the wrong button, but that totally worked! That's awesome! Ooh, into the cameras. Right, and here's your Raiders of the Lost Ark reference. Which, I'm not good at dodging these. Ah! Bats! Oh, come on! Why does this game need to have bats in it? Excuse me, Fuego. I forget what your name is, kid. Dang it. I really like Dig Dug, too. Why can't I remember your name? Damn, I'm a huge Dig Dug fan. Man. Oh. You're not Kratos, Lucas. That's not how it works. Yeah, Lucas is an interesting character. He's isn't in a ton of the book, but he's in a... I think he's a pretty interesting character. He's one of the ones I remember most of. I'm pretty sure the next one's name is Todd Ingram, but I don't remember a lot about him off the top of my head. Clash at Demon Head, I think Todd plays for Clash at Demon Head. Because I said in the last episode, Ow, dang it. Yeah, I'm reviving. Dang it, don't make me do that level all over again. Aw, man. Okay. Dang it. If nothing interesting happens, I'll see you in a minute. I hate this enemies. God, the sprite work for this game is gorgeous, though. So, actually, I do have something else I can talk about, and I might end up bringing this up in a later episode, but if you're a fan of Gravity Falls and you've seen the episode Fight Fighters, the guest stars who did the people who did the animation for that episode on Rumble McSkirmish were the same people who did the sprite work for this game, for the original version of this game, in 2010, which is pretty dang impressive. Just a really cool collaboration there. Ah, I hate when you can't kill an enemy you really want to get to kill in a game. Okay, right. This happens right here with Lucas Lee in the background, just dealing with Mutagen. Sweet. Okay, we're gonna race up here and Yeah, a great detail you'll notice is that when you knock them over, they desperately put their lens caps up in the air so that they don't get destroyed. Which is a great detail. Again, a ton of personality on the enemies. And we're at the funny number. Let's go. Oops. There we go. Okay, not too much of a run back to this part. Oh man, I thought I could dodge the bats. Ah! God, they're hard to hit. I do love you can use the key as a legitimate item, and it's a pretty tough one. And the midair throw for the win. Yeah. So yeah, that is a Kratos reference, trying to punch the chest. Well, it may be. I don't know if that was introduced before God of War 2018. And then Arturus, whatever his son's name is, sorry. I'm not a God of War fan, I don't know what his son's name is, sorry. Whatever Kratos' son's name is, he tried to do that in Ragnarok. I do know that much. Ow. Stupid pyrotechnics. There we go. Broke the cheeky statue. There's something I can do with this, I think. I can hit in the air. Cool. There was something suspicious there. Okay, I can pick it up. Cool. Oh boy. Dang it! Stunt doubles. Oh shoot, he got angry. Oh cool, I have a dodge now. Nice. Okay, I have a rush dodge now. That's nice. Okay, that'll give me some more traction. So, a fact I know about Canadian currency is that the picture of the bird on the $1 coin is a loon. Like, the bird type, the loon. I know that much. Because, like, in the word doubloon, a type of coin, there's that word as well. Loon. Wordplay. I think there's a reference here, but I'm not sure what it is. Oh, I know what this is. Street Fighter, baby. Oh, come on. That's cheap. God, that was close. That was cheap. And there's Lee. Again. Oh, hey Wallace, hey Neil. Yeah, I remember, I recognize this. Whoops, almost closed my game. Hey Lucas Lee. Okay, I don't remember if this is an easy fight or not. Alright, because Lucas Lee is a really tough guy. But then again, I did buy... Who knew? Right, because then, this part. That part is really funny in the book. Okay, only proper context, you'll understand. That's such a good moment. Ooh, a skateboard. Wait, I can't use that. Scott doesn't know how to skate. Well, that fight was a lot faster than I thought it would be. Because, like, in the book, Lucas Lee, like, literally demolishes Scott at first. Yeah. All the people I have defeated. Love. Leo's place. Yeah, that has to do with book 3, if I remember correctly. A lot shorter than I thought for this episode, but that's honestly fine by me. That is going to do it for this episode, and this will conclude my second episode of Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, the game, complete edition. Thank you all so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed it. I will try and make another one soon. With all that being said, I'm loving this game. I'm having a great time with it. If you liked it, make sure to subscribe, comment, like, and hit that bell. All that said, I'm Paul Westerfield, and I'll see you all next time.